students, in the last lecture we did learn that how a supercharger works and what is the purpose of supercharger in a CI engine. Okay, so in short I will review about that, and in this lecture we will learn that what is turbocharger and how it is different from that of supercharger. Okay, so in supercharger what happens, that you can see that over the inlet valve of the engine a compressor is applied, centrifugal compressor. Okay, so what happens in the suction stroke, when suction stroke executes, you can see piston is moving from top dead center to bottom dead center, so it is pulling the air inside, as well as this compressor is also forcing more air to go inside. Okay, you can see that this compressor is connected to this inlet valve, so it is forcing the air. Since it is a compressor, it is taking the air from the atmosphere and trying to force the air to go inside the cylinder. Okay, so when piston moves in suction stroke, then what happens, that forcefully more amount of air goes inside the cylinder. So more amount of air means what? More oxygen availability. It means what? It can burn more amount of diesel, and more amount of diesel is burned, more heat developed, and more heat developed means more work done, and like this way the total work output of the engine improves, as well as the efficiency of the engine also improves. Okay, so in detail about supercharging you will learn in my other lecture, you can find it in the same channel. Now we will talk about what is turbocharging. Okay, now in case I ask you that this is the compressor of supercharger. Okay, so how it runs, because it is compressor, it means what? It needs work input. So how work input happens with this compressor of supercharger? Okay, one way is by the help of this crankshaft itself we can provide the power. For example, a belt is connected, you can see this is a belt from the crankshaft, it is connected to this rotor of this compressor. So by this way some amount of work output of this crankshaft is invested to run this compressor. Okay, so this is one way to run the compressor of supercharger. But what happens in that case, the availability of work output over the crankshaft will be reduced. For useful purpose the availability will be reduced, because some amount of work will be lost to run the rotor of the supercharger. Okay, now one other way is using a turbocharger. What is a turbocharger? See, when the exhaust stroke takes place, then what happens, exhaust gases, okay, high temperature exhaust gases comes out from the cylinder. Okay, we know this thing that there are four strokes in an engine: suction, compression, working and exhaust. And in exhaust stroke what happens, the burnt gases are expelled out of the cylinder. The exhaust gases are with very high temperatures, you know the temperature of a CI engine exhaust gas can be as high as 450 degrees centigrade. It means what? The exhaust gases contains heat energy with them. That heat energy can be converted into work done by the help of some engine, and that is what happening in turbocharging. You can see that in turbocharging there is a gas turbine system. Okay, this red colored component is the turbine, a gas turbine, and this blue colored entity is a compressor. What happens, whatever the exhaust gases which are coming out of the cylinder in the exhaust stroke passes through this gas turbine. Okay, so what happens, since the exhaust gases contains energy with them, it converts into work done in the turbine and ultimately leaves this turbine, ultimately goes to the atmosphere. Okay, but before going to the atmosphere, some amount of heat energy converts into mechanical energy or work done in the turbine itself. Whatever energy which is developed in this turbine is supplied to the compressor of supercharger, okay, which takes the air from the atmosphere and forces the air to go inside the cylinder when the suction stroke executes. Okay, so in this case what happens, the work done required for running the compressor of supercharger is recovered by the help of gas turbine, and that gas turbine runs by the help of the waste gases. Okay, otherwise what is happening, whatever the exhaust gases are, they are dispensed to the atmosphere without any use. Okay, so those gases are passing through the turbine developing work, and that work in turn is used for running the compressor of supercharger, and like this way supercharging is taking place. So what happens in supercharging, in case we are not using this method, means running the compressor by the help of crankshaft itself, in that case also by supercharging efficiency improves. But in case of turbocharging the efficiency improves to even more levels, because whatever work required by the compressor is required by the waste gases, is required by the exhaust gases themselves. Okay, so the work output of the crankshaft remain intact. Okay, whatever work output is there, the same can be converted into useful work. No amount has to be invested to the compressor. Okay, so this is what the concept of turbocharging, and in short story I have explained this to you. Thank you.